wrestler Bret the Hitman Hart knew Chris Benoit very well. They were lifelong friends. Bret Hart joins us live from Calgary. Good evening, Bret. And I'm, you know, sorry about the tragedy, horrible thing, this wife and child. And, of course, you know, he murdered them, so I'm having a little problem with him. But how long did you know Bret?
I've known Chris.
Chris. I'm sorry, Chris.
I knew him, I'm guessing, probably from the time he was maybe 10, 11, maybe 12 years old.
How did you know him?
He was an avid wrestling fan. I remember him from the front row or thereabouts. He was a huge wrestling fan when I first started, and I can remember when my father brought him back to the dressing room when he was a small, just a kid, and brought him back to meet myself and the Dynamite Kid and my brother Keith, and I met him, and he was this remarkable little kid that was obsessed with wrestling, and he wanted to meet his hero, who was the Dynamite Kid. And just a few years later, he learned how to wrestle, maybe when he was 16 or 17, and he knew from a very early age that he was going to become a wrestler. I mean, his whole life was wrestling, you know, from beginning to end.
Was he any good? I mean, I know they won some championships, but, I mean, what was it about him?
He was great. He was one of the best. He was a guy that was loved by everybody in the dressing room. Even the biggest wrestlers and the real tough guys in the dressing room respected Chris Benoit. Everybody loved him. He was a guy that reached down and helped the young guys starting out. He had a lot of respect for the guys that worked really hard. And he was in the dressing room, he would have been a leader that sort of carried the ball and worked really hard and set an example for everyone else. And I know that everybody in the wrestling business is reeling from this. He was a guy that no one would have expected this to come from Chris Benoit. He was a easygoing, lovable kind of guy. I don't remember him being moody or bad-tempered or violent in any way at all. He was a guy that was a very caring, supportive kind of guy. He supported me in a lot of situations, and it's a shock to everybody.
I know that, Bret, that you spoke to Chris, he has two children from another relationship. You spoke to the older of the two. What did you say, and what did he say tonight?
Well, they're hanging in there, the whole family. They're a tough family, and they're a strong family, and I don't think anyone saw this coming. I think, you know, they're as confused by it as everyone else is. He's trying to stay strong, and the families, you know, I spoke to Chris's sister, and they're just devastated by it, but at the same time, they're a strong family, and they're going to get through it, and they're just going to pull themselves up from this, you know.
Did you know if Chris used steroids?
I'm sure that he's used them through his career. I'm guessing, but I never ever saw him personally take them, and understanding, and I think, you know, I don't have no reason to blur the truth, but I think that when Eddie Guerrero died a year and a half ago or 2 years ago, the WWE put in a really strong drug testing policy, and they've been trying to stamp out steroids. And I know from talking to other wrestlers that a lot of them were really careful not to have anything in their system, and they seem to be a very serious test. And so I'm of the conviction at this point that steroids probably, if they were in his house, they were for maybe something that he had stockpiled or maybe was planning on using. I don't know, but I don't believe that if they tested him just a few months ago and he was clean, I suspect that he was obliging the tests and following the rules.
One quick question. We have 30 seconds. Let me just ask you a quick question. We have 30 seconds left. Do you know if there's something wrong with Daniel, his son?
I never knew of anything to be wrong with him at all. I was a little surprised to hear that he had autism, and this stuff about him being a dwarf. I never saw him as a dwarf, and I never heard Chris ever.
And you saw this child? You saw this child and didn't think he looked particularly small?
He may have looked a little small, but Chris looked a little small, too. You know, Chris was not the biggest guy in the world, either. So, I just thought he was, you know, I wouldn't have noticed it enough to make a real fair assessment of that.
Well, Bret, thank you very much for joining us.
My pleasure.
Coming up, what does Paris...